All right, Prime Minister Narendra Modi will be inaugurating the completed section of Kanpur Metro Rail project any moment now. We're getting the live visuals coming in at the moment. This is the push coming in Kanpur. He's sounding off the poll bugle in poll-bound Uttar Pradesh. Prime Minister Modi to inaugurate the metro service. And we're getting live visuals of the Prime Minister in Kanpur at the moment. The Bina Panki multi-product pipeline project also, along with the Kanpur Metro Rail project. We'll get you all the very latest details. The UP Industrial Hub now on Metro Map. Latest coming in from State of War, Uttar Pradesh. Uttar Pradesh goes into elections. All parties in election mode right now. And sounding off the poll bugle, you've got the BJP sounding it off right there with the inauguration of this metro project. The metro has reached the banks of River Ganga. This is an inauguration done by the Prime Minister of the completed section of the Kanpur Metro Rail project and Bina Panki multi-product pipeline project.
उन लिफ्टों में भी इसी तकनीक का प्रयोग किया गया है कि जब भी लिफ्ट ऑपरेट होगी, जब भी लिफ्ट चलेगी, तो उसे जो एनर्जी निकलेगी, उस एनर्जी का जो प्रयोग है, वो दोबारा से कर सकते हैं और करीब
The latest coming in right there, Prime Minister Modi to begin his 9-kilometer metro ride from IIT at the moment and also going to be inaugurating 1500 crore rupees pipeline project. You can see the Prime Minister sitting in the metro at the moment. Accompanying him on his right is Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath, UP Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath right there. BJP surely sounding the poll bugle at the moment in poll-bound Uttar Pradesh. The metro is reaching banks of River Ganga. This is Modi's metro ride. And this is a 9-kilometer metro ride from the IIT. The Prime Minister's visual optics right there of sitting in the metro himself and inaugurating this. So UP Industrial Hub now on the metro map. You can see the Prime Minister and UP Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath in that metro. They've begun their nine kilometer ride in the metro. The metro is going to be reaching the banks of River Ganga. Prime Minister Narendra Modi is in Kanpur. We'll also get our reporters to bring you up to speed with the latest itinerary of Prime Minister Narendra Modi. There is going to be a likely address once he reaches, after he finishes this 9-kilometer long ride. That's perhaps on his itinerary. We'll continue to get you those visuals right there. We've lost those visuals. All right, they're back right here. Samarth is now joining us. Samarth, is very beautiful what I can see. The metro views from inside to the outside looks quite world-class, like what you see overseas. And this is in UP at the moment, being inaugurated by the Prime Minister. Samarth?
So yes, Kanpur is excited as this is a big thing for Kanpur city, as the Kanpur metro is finally getting inaugurated. Can show you the visuals out here. However, the entire road has been blocked by the police personnel. But if you see the front picture, this is the entrance from where it symbolizes that this is the IIT Kanpur area where the metro station is. And Prime Minister has just visited inside few minutes back from IIT College after attending the 54th. Convocation there. So it's a big thing for Kanpur city, and this Vikas pitch will gain some momentum for BJP in the elections or not? This is what we will get to know in some months. But what is crucial is Prime Minister's back-to-back wins in Uttar Pradesh, and he is inside the metro station. He will move from IIT to another metro station, and thereafter he will leave to Aryanagar for the rally place, where he will have a public address for the people of Kanpur. And it is worth mentioning here that around 27 seats comes in the Kanpur Mandal. So it is very important that how earlier it was Purvanchal and now Kanpur Mandal. So each and every part of Uttar Pradesh is being covered by the back-to-back visits of Prime Minister, be it in Prayagraj, be it in Gorakhpur, be it in Varanasi and now Kanpur. So this is very crucial, and not only Prime Minister, it's a staff hour from the BJP. As today Amit Shah is in Hardoi and Varanasi, while JP Nadda in Hapur. So it's a power-packed show for BJP, not just BJP, even opposition is trying their best. As the SPC Akhilesh Yadav is in Unnao, he will have the Harath Yatra. But what is crucial before UP elections, that UP government, Yogi government, will not want to leave any stone unturned, and that is why the inauguration and laying foundation ceremonies are taking place with each passing day. And before the election comes into thing, as the election commission is already in Lucknow for the Omicron thing, and they will also hold a press conference on 30th. So it is very crucial that maybe the dates could be announced, maybe some announcement regarding the Omicron take place. But what is important is the Kanpur Metro, as it's a big thing for the people of Kanpur. While SP, the Twitter handle of Samajwadi Party, has claimed that Akhilesh Yadav late foundation is stone in 2016. So that's very clear and evident that how both major parties, SP and BJP, are having a fight before UP polls. But what is benefiting Uttar Pradesh is the foundation link ceremonies, is the inaugurations of various projects, be it the Amul milk plant in Varanasi or this Kanpur Metro in the city of Kanpur. Yes.
That's right. Samad is getting us those updates. Samad, also tell us a little about how world-class this metro is. Over to you.
Well, this metro is the future for the city. So far, the 9-kilometer stretch has been completed, in which 9 metro stations will be there. There will be 6 metro trains with 3 coaches each. And for today, it will start after Narendra Modi. Around 200 children will be seated inside the metro with girls and boys. So it's going to be very, very crucial how things are happening in Lucknow Metro. And it is going to be fully air-conditioned, and various protocols will also be followed. So these are the things how, and that is why the metro is very crucial. It was the need of the hour for Kanpur. Earlier it was just in Lucknow Metro, and it's worth mentioning.
Let's re-establish that connection right there to Samad. Samad is getting us the details about the metro as well. Samad will join us back again and explain to us a little more about this specific metro. Samad is back. Samad, also tell us, from what point to what point is this metro going to take people? When is it going to launch? When can the common man go to take the metro ride as well? How world-class it is, and how this is a big development push coming in? Samarth? All right, Samarth is going to be joining us in just about moments from now. We'll try and reestablish that connection to our reporter on ground, who's getting us the latest updates as far as this metro inauguration is concerned. It's a mecca Vikas push in Kanpur. Just look at that, it's quite beautiful. We're getting you those visuals on your screens. Really very beautiful. And the metro also looks quite state-of-the-art. This is a much-needed development push coming in for India. It's a 9-kilometer-long metro ride from IIT to Gita Nagar. And there is going to be a 1,500 crore rupees pipeline project as well. And of course, there is politics that is breaking out, because the Samajwadi Party has also claimed that they were the ones to lay the foundation stone of this particular metro project in 2016. And there will be politicking on the back of this, because clearly you can see the BJP sounding of the poll bugle right there in poll-bound Uttar Pradesh. It's a state-of-the-art metro that is being inaugurated. It's very, very beautiful. The visuals from inside the metro also, we're getting you at the moment, looking outside, also quite beautiful, and really putting India on the map as far as development is concerned. 1,500 crore rupees pipeline project also is going to be inaugurated by the Prime Minister. Prime Minister is accompanied by UP Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath. Samarth is on the phone line. Samarth, tell us, from what point to what point is this metro going to take? What is the cost of this project? When can the common man start boarding this particular metro? And how this is state of the art, like what you see around the world?
This metro will run from 6 a.m. to 10 p.m. and it will be available for the normal public by tomorrow. And if you talk about the fare, it will be around 10 rupees, and for the card holders, it will be lessened by 10% at the overall fees. So So it's going to be very crucial. And if you talk about the other things, then it's a 9-kilometer stretch in which will cover around 9 stations of metro. And but as traffic jam is the major issue for the Kanpur metro, so it's going to be very crucial and game changer for the city of Kanpur. And that is why it was very important that IIT Kanpur, from IIT Kanpur, it will be Moti Jhil. So this is the stretch from where the metro will start and end. Yes.
Right, Samarth. Samarth, also, what is the kind of politicking that is going on the back of this inauguration?
Well, exactly. Politics is also on over the entire issue. The Samajwadi Party Twitter handle has obviously tweeted the picture in which it could be seen Akhilesh Yadav laying foundation stone off the Kanpur metro. So these things are happening out here, and it's very crucial now as BJP is getting replied to. But on each and every project, it is happening. So this is going to be very crucial. But we'll see that how it takes place. But as the project was, you know, was maybe the foundation link ceremony could have been by Akhilesh Yadav, but it was inaugurated by Yogi Adityanath government. Yes.
Was the foundation stone laid by Samajwadi Party in 2016?
Yes.
All right, let's re-establish that connection right there to Samarth in just about a bit. The metro has reached the banks of River Ganga. It's a 9-kilometer ride from IIT to Geetanagar. We're tracking that ride here on India Today. You can see that metro, state of the art. Prime Minister Narendra Modi with Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath sounding off the pole bugle in pole-bound Uttar Pradesh with this development project. So we're getting you the live visuals of the Mega Vikas push in Kanpur, and Samarth will be joining us for more details. At the moment, you can see a lot of VVIP movement right there at the moment as the Prime Minister is inaugurating this metro project. The Prime Minister along with UP Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath right there on your screens, walking out of the metro. A huge development push coming in for India. On your screens right now, all the live visuals and latest details coming in from Kanpur. He addressed the students at Kanpur just a while back at the IIT Kanpur. And now the metro has reached the banks of River Ganga. So from IIT Kanpur to Geetanagar, this metro is connecting 9 kilometers. It will also reduce traffic, as Samarth was mentioning. It will reduce the cars on the roads too. And look at that state-of-the-art facility right there. Samarth is back with us. Samarth, this is also going to be reducing the traffic on the roads, right? Because more people can now take the metro.
Yeah, obviously, Kanpur is something... Be it Kanpur or Varanasi, they deal with the problem of traffic jam, and that is why it becomes very crucial that metro should be made. And because the traffic hassle gets stopped once metro comes into action, Lucknow is a classic example, and now Varanasi is also in plan, Gorakhpur is also in plan, but what is completed is the 9-kilometer stretch of the Kanpur metro. So this is the thing which will take forward, and there shouldn't be any politics in these kind of things because it is all about the development. And it seems that the 7th party is raising on this particular Vikas, because whenever the Prime Minister is coming to UP, he's launching the various projects. So it may be possible that the rain foundation ceremony could have happened during other government, but the one government whoever is doing it is important. That is why BJP is sitting back at SP, that SPP is taking credit of each and everything being inaugurated by BJP. While on the other hand, Akhilesh claims that the projects were the vision of Samajwadi Party and was somewhere and somehow it started or laid foundation stone of these projects. So that is why it's a war of words. Whenever PM arrives and whenever he inaugurates various projects, be it the Amul plan, be it the Purvanchal Expressway or the Kanpur Metro, the war of words always on between the two parties.
Yes, but what are the facts? When was the foundation laying stone laid for this metro project?
Well, the foundation name ceremony was happened in 2016 as per the Akhilesh Yadav too, as per the tweet of the Mahagathi party. It could be seen that he shared a picture in which Akhilesh could be seen with Union Minister Venkaiah Naidu and BJP leader Murali Manohar Joshi laying foundation of Kanpur, of Kanpur Metro. So it becomes very crucial that though the trial done was given green signal by the Yogi Adityanath government in 2019, but these are things which are making things difficult, because as per BJP government, the work started in 2019 by Yogi Adityanath government, and then the pre-run, the trial run taking place in 2020. But what is important is the war of words, because UP elections are almost knocking the doors. And with such war of words between these two political parties, each and every project being inaugurated by the Prime Minister of India becomes crucial. And with UP elections on the doors, it's up to public that will decide that who made what in the polls before UP. Yes.
All right. The metro has now reached the banks of River Ganga, Samarth. What next? What's on the itinerary? The line has been disconnected, and Samarth will be joining us again in just about a bit, getting all the very latest details right there. But for now, going across to my colleague Akshita, who's bringing you more details about the Kanpur Metro project. Akshita?
Prime Minister Modi is inaugurating the phase one of the Kanpur Metro. And let's get your details about this project. It's happening at a cost of 11,000 crore rupees. That's the entire metro project. There are two phases in all. The first phase is ready. That's what the Prime Minister is inaugurating. Now, the first phase in all, completes about 9 kilometers. It covers 9 kilometers in all of Kanpur. From IIT Kanpur all the way to Nobasta is phase one of the Kanpur Metro. Now, in phase one itself, in that 9 kilometer stretch, there are about 8 stopovers, 8 stations, and this will be hugely useful for locals. It is, in fact, going to be hugely beneficial for locals, so much so that officials say that there could be a footfall of about 6 lakh people per day by 2024. And by then, both phases, it's expected, will be ready.
Fresh credit war erupts in UP as Prime Minister Modi inaugurates Kanpur Metro. The Samajwadi Party shared an image that claimed was of Akhilesh laying the foundation stone for this project. Samajwadi Party Twitter handle has shared a picture of Akhilesh Yadav. You can see that on your screens in the presence of Venkaiah Naidu and BJP leader Murali Manohar Joshi. BJP was quick to mock the credit claiming bid. Party spokesperson Shehzad Poonawalla released a series of memes that showed Akhilesh laying claim to historic monuments in a bid to lampoon him. The Samajwadi Party had earlier claimed that Kashi Vishwanath Corridor and expressways unveiled by Modi are their own projects.
जो समाजवादी सरकार ने दी थी मेट्रो, उसी का उद्घाटन करने जा रहे हैं। ये मेट्रो पहले बनकर के तैयार हो जाती, लेकिन हमारे मुख्यमंत्री नाकाम और अनुपयोगी मुख्यमंत्री ने समय लगा लगा करके इतना समय लगाया कि आज 4.5 साल हो गए, तब जाकर के पूरा हुआ है।
So we'll have a break when we return. Mumbai and Delhi lead India's Omicron caseload.